How to highlight, color, focus, and customize the mouse cursor pointer with magnifier properties and more.
Subject: This is a detailed tutorial on how to use the free programs Mouse Pointer Highlight and Microsoft PowerToys and Microsoft Windows Screen Magnifier. In your training seminars and presentations, we will share with you three applications that will provide you and your target audience with great convenience so that you can easily follow your mouse pointer and stay focused.
Highlight your mouse pointer during presentation or teaching. You can make it easier to track your mouse cursor and mouse movements and see your mouse keystrokes.
We have prepared for you this practical tutorial that shows you step by step how to highlight or focus and customize the mouse cursor pointer for your audience or for you.
Making your mouse pointer and clicks more prominent by highlighting them is especially important and can be very useful during presentations, demos, online or distance learning, and projecting your monitor onto a screen or screen recording. Customize your cursor so that both you and your audience can see and follow it. Many applications such as OBS, Teams, Zoom, Webex work seamlessly with these customizations and tools.
In this lesson, we will show you how to use Microsoft PowerToys software and Mouse Pointer Highlight software practically. In the last section, we will also show you the detailed use of the magnifier tool, one of the Windows tools that provides the function of magnifying a specific area of the screen around the mouse cursor or the entire screen.
We will also show how these software tools work together, either on their own or collectively. We will then examine the benefits and results we get when we run the three applications together. To access my first application, or to install it if it is not installed, we can go to the Microsoft Store link from the Start menu, or we can type the name of the Microsoft Store link in the Start menu, and it will appear immediately.
Open the Microsoft Store link by clicking on the symbol. Once Microsoft Store is open, we can search for the application by typing Microsoft PowerToys in the search field. Immediately after the search, the Microsoft PowerToys application appears and I select it. There is a prominent install option that you can easily see. Simply click to start the installation and it will download and complete quickly and automatically.
After the installation, we can immediately move on to the steps of using the software. Microsoft PowerToys application has many features. In this tutorial, we will focus more on the mouse utilities.
The first mouse utility we'll look at is called Find My Mouse. It creates a circular spotlight effect that focuses on the position of the mouse cursor and can darken areas outside of it.
One of the most important mouse utility tools we will use is the mouse highlighter. A mouse highlighter is a tool that highlights clicks with colored circles around the cursor when left or right mouse buttons are clicked. The third mouse utility tool of the Microsoft PowerToys application is the Mouse Pointer Crosshairs tool. The mouse pointer crosshair draws a screen-sized crosshair centering the mouse pointer. It makes it easy to show where the mouse pointer is on the screen. It also makes it easier to focus on where the mouse pointer is, as with other tools. It has customizable settings according to our preferences. The second different application that we will explain in a practical way is called Mouse Pointer Highlight. It is also very simple to install.
After opening the Microsoft Store, we can search for the application by typing Mouse Pointer Highlight in the search section and start the installation immediately after finding it. Simply click to start the installation and the application will download and install itself quickly and automatically. This software, like the others, is a free application.
The Mouse Pointer Highlight application is much simpler and has two basic features that we will use.
The first is the Mouse Pointer Highlight, a circular colored highlight that permanently follows the cursor as long as the program is running. It looks like a halo around the mouse pointer that helps focus and attracts attention. The program installs immediately and is ready to run. When we click open, the program opens automatically and a permanent yellow mouse cursor highlight appears around my mouse cursor with the usual settings.
We'll close the application for now and talk about its features and customization preferences in detail later. Now, we have both apps installed and usable.
First of all, we will examine the mouse utilities settings and detailed analysis of the Microsoft PowerToys software that we first installed. We go to the settings section of the software and then select the mouse utilities section.
Mouse utilities are tools that improve mouse and cursor functions. The mouse helper tool at the very beginning is called Find My Mouse. It creates a circular spotlight effect that focuses on the position of the mouse cursor and can darken areas outside it.
In order to use this feature, there are two activation methods while the program is running. I can choose one of them as activation method by pressing the control key two times or by shaking the mouse cursor left and right quickly. As soon as I click the right or left mouse button, the Find My Mouse feature is deactivated to activate it again. We can use the activation method we have chosen. We prefer to activate it with the control key two times.
We can also set cursor focus, where the screen is darkened except for a circular area around the cursor for cursor focus and ease of viewing.
In my settings, I can preferably change the size of the spot circle area, and I can also change the color and transparency properties of the spot circle area and the darkened area. I can also increase or decrease the animation speed of the spotlight effect.
The second and one of the most important mouse utility tools is the mouse highlighter. The mouse highlighter is a tool that highlights clicks with colored circles around the cursor when the left or right mouse buttons are clicked.
First of all, I change the activation shortcut of this tool according to my preference. I change my activation keys to the shortcut combination Windows plus Alt plus Space.
When I press the combination keys Windows plus Alt plus Space while the program is running in the background, the left and right mouse clicks will be highlighted as different colors on the screen.
We can change the size, color, transparency, and display time of the mouse click highlights according to our own preferences.
The third mouse utility tool of Microsoft PowerToys, which we briefly mentioned earlier, is the mouse pointer crosshairs tool. The mouse pointer crosshair draws a screen-sized crosshair centered on the mouse pointer.
I change the activation shortcut of the tool according to my preference. I change my activation keys to the shortcut combination Windows plus Control plus X.
When I press the combination keys Windows plus Control plus X while the program is running in the background, the mouse pointer crosshairs tool is now actively displayed on the screen. And of course, the mouse pointer crosshairs tool can also be used with other tools. It makes it easy to show where the mouse pointer is on the screen. It also makes it easier to focus on where the mouse pointer is, as with other tools. It has customizable settings according to our preferences. We can also customize the appearance and behavior of this tool. We can change the transparency, color, thickness, and many other properties according to your preferences.
The mouse utilities from Microsoft PowerToys are very nice, but not enough for us. A very important and necessary feature for us is that the mouse cursor has a permanent highlight that does not disappear with a click. For this reason, we will also use the mouse pointer highlight software. Let's open the mouse pointer highlight program by itself and examine its settings in detail. In a moment, we will use it together with Microsoft PowerToys software. But first, we open mouse pointer highlight by itself.
As soon as the mouse pointer highlight software is turned on, a permanent mouse pointer highlight feature is activated around my mouse cursor, which appears in yellow color with normal settings.
We can change the properties of the mouse pointer highlight tool, such as size, color, transparency, etc., according to our preferences. The basic function of the mouse pointer highlighter is to create a colored halo around the mouse cursor.
The second important tool is the mouse click pointer highlight, which highlights clicks with a colored circle around the cursor when left or right mouse buttons are clicked.
However, the single color property is the same for both clicks. In other words, it does not offer separate color options for left or right clicks. There is no distinction between left and right.
We can immediately change the size, color and transparency of the mouse click pointer highlight tool
as well as the time it appears on the screen, according to our preferences, or we can disable it if we wish. We prefer mouse pointer highlight because it has a permanent mouse pointer highlighting feature that is active as long as the program is running in the background. It has an active and permanent mouse pointer highlighting feature, whether there is a click or not. I can use the mouse pointer highlight software tools together with the mouse utilities of the Microsoft PowerToys application. This way we will be able to use the mouse pointer highlighting feature provided by the mouse pointer highlighting software, which will remain active as long as the program is running in the background. And even Microsoft PowerToys has the second and one of the most important mouse pointer utilities, mouse highlighter. Mouse highlighter. When left or right mouse buttons are clicked, we will use two different colored circles around the cursor for left and right clicks, and we will be able to highlight the click separately. In this way, we can use a feature that is better in one software in combination with different features that serve similar purposes in another software. Our preference is to have a permanent mouse pointer highlighting feature that is active as long as the program is running in the background. And when left or right mouse buttons are clicked, they are highlighted separately with two different colors. We can access both of these features by running two different apps simultaneously in the background. Now, we come to the last part of our tutorial, the magnifying glass tool. One of the PI installed and usual tools in Windows, it allows you to zoom in and magnify the entire screen or a specific part of it. For this, we will not do any download or installation because, as we have mentioned, it is a ready and installed tool in the Windows operating system. To access the application, I type magnifier from the start menu and it appears with a lenticular symbol. I start by selecting the magnifier application. As soon as the application is opened, it opens with its default settings. By default, a long strip area magnifier placed at the top of the screen operates the magnifier features at mouse cursor level. However, we do not want to run it in this setting and immediately open it by clicking on the General Settings section in the opening panel of the application. We can choose the full screen magnifier feature instead of the dot setting, or we can choose the third option, which is the limited frame that we set, that is, the lens setting and the magnifier feature that follows the mouse cursor. Shortcut, key combination, Windows and plus to activate the magnifier application. Press Windows and Escape to close the application. Shortcut key combinations are available for all three options. We usually prefer the lens setting. We can also change the size ratios with shortcut key combinations. First, shortcut combination for magnification Windows and plus. Windows and minus for minimization, or we can zoom in and out with Control Alt mouse wheel. In the lens settings, we can change the width or height of the lens size and the coverage size according to our preferences. The Magnifier app also has a screen reader TTS feature. We can change the speed of the voiceover and the type of voice in the settings. There are different types of AR voices. I need to select read to activate the app.
And hold Control and Alt and rotate the wheel on your mouse to zoom in or out.
That sound is coming now. When the read feature is active, it can start reading a text on the screen from the section I have selected. As I mentioned before, we can choose a different voice.
Press and hold Control plus Alt and rotate the wheel on your mouse to zoom in or out.
I activate the read feature and we can also voice the actions and commands I do on the computer. For example, a file on the desktop or the name of an application.
Recycle bin. OBS Studio.
Even if we close and reopen the program, our settings and preferences will remain the same, unless we change them. We can use these three applications, which we have examined in detail and practically, simultaneously, and benefit from the tools they provide. We leave it to your appreciation and evaluation of how much such auxiliary tools can contribute to our presentation and narration work in screen sharing or presentations, trainings, or live broadcasts that we will prepare. And so we complete this content. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon, and thanks for watching.